Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And on a recent live stream, someone asked, hey, using the paginated report, can I give the user the ability to select which columns they want to show and not show in a Tablex visual? And I said, of course you can. In this video, I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, okay, paginated reports. During the live stream, someone's like, Patrick, Adam, got a Tablex visual on my paginated report, but I want to give my report consumers the ability to select which columns they want to show in it. Can you do it? And I was like, of course. So here's the video. So you know what I would like to do? Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I've created a basic report connected to a Power BI data set, and I created a data set using all my values, and I create a little Tablex visual here with a title, and it's an expression. So basically the expression says, give me the value from the calendar parameter and concatenate it with Salesforce to the country parameter. And so when my report consumer runs this, what I'd like to do is give them the ability to remove columns. So I'll choose a year, I'll choose a country. They have this drop down where they could choose or unselect which the columns I don't want. And since in the title, we include the year and the country, I don't want to include those in the table. And so when they click view report, it should omit those. Well, it doesn't work. So how do you do it? The first thing you need to do is you create this parameter list. There's some variations if you go out and search on the web where you can use a Boolean value. You can have a true false for each one of the columns that you want to choose. So yes for this column, no for that column. I decided to do a multi-select drop down. I thought that was a little more efficient. And so you create this parameter, you just right click, choose new parameter, and you can write a query to populate the available values. I just hard coded them. This is what the report consumer would see, and this is the actual value it's going to look for to determine if it should show or not. And this value should equal to the column name in your data set. So year, quarter, month should be the exact same. And so you just add one for each one, or you can write a query. So I click OK. In a paginated report, there's lots of properties, but there is a property under the visibility for hidden, and for everything that you add by default, is set to false. You don't want to hide it. You can set it on the column. You can set it on the header. You can click in the column row and you can see that property. But don't use either one of those and go into the properties. You don't want to do that. What you want to do is select one, right click on it and go to column visibility. And then you'll see these options. Click on the radio button labeled show or hide based on an expression. Click on the function and now we're going to write an expression. And this is really interesting because a lot of people don't realize that you can expand these out and actually see what all of these do. And I'm actually going to start with the logical if. And so it's going to return something based on something. So if you just double click it, actually writes it for you. And then I'm going to go to text because I want to use this in string. It returns an integer if it finds the occurrence of a string. Because I have a multi-value select dropdown, I want to join that together in a single list. And then I'm going to see if one of the items, the year, the quarter, is in that list. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this function called join. And what I'm going to do is go to my parameter, and the parameter I want is this show hide columns. Be sure to get rid of this zero at the end, and this join just joins it together into a comma delimited list or whatever type of list you specify in that second parameter. And you can see I'm using a comma here. And for each one of these columns, this can get a little tedious. You need to specify the name of the column. And for this one, it would be year. If this in string finds an index of greater than zero, I want to say false, keep it hidden. Otherwise, don't hide it. I'm going to close this and I'll click OK and then click OK. So now when I run this, choose select value 2014. I mean the year, choose France, and I'm gonna select all for now. I'm gonna choose view report. And what you'll see is everything is. But if I unselect year and do it again, watch what happens. Year goes away. To make this happen for all the columns, you need to repeat the steps that I just showed you. So we're gonna grab that expression, not lazy, we're just efficient. So we're gonna grab that expression, copy this, get on our clipboard, right click, column visibility, choose the expression, paste it in there. And this time we're gonna replace year, quarter, click okay. And then what I'm gonna do is run the report. And now, right, choose 2013. Let's choose Germany this time. And select everything, but no year, quarter, view. And now you can see that it's get rid of year, quarter. Now, like a cooking show, I've repeated the step for each one of them. I'm gonna choose view report. And what I'm gonna do is unselect year and country because I don't wanna see the year and country. Run this, and what you're gonna see is that it only includes quarter, month, and the ones, because I don't need year and country because it's already there. It just kind of works. Now, this is not actually changing the structure of the query that's being sent to the source. This is only hiding the column. If you need to change the structure of the query, you need to make a dynamic SQL expression, a DAX expression to do something like that. If you want to solve it that way, if you just merely want to hide the columns, this solution should work for you. All right. What do you think? No paginated reports could do this? Did you come up with a different way, a more efficient way to solve this problem? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy on the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.